What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. I am Nick, here with Ty and Ryan.
Howdy.
Now, today, we have one of my favorite artists, Stevie Ray Vaughan. Huge name. Please tell me you have heard the name.
Yes.
Okay.
I told you, I almost did a song by him today, actually.
Okay, so, if you guys had to guess, how many SRV songs do you actually know?
Two.
Yeah, I was like,
really?
Maybe one or two.
One or two.
So, you know Pride and Joy.
Everyone knows Pride and Joy.
So, what's the second one you know?
I'm sure I've heard one. That's the thing. Okay. I'm saying I'm just going to throw in one by default. That's what I'm saying. Like, I always know one for sure. But
put a little insurance on it.
Yeah, I'm going to throw that extra one in there just by default. Because when I hear it, I'm like, oh, I heard this.
So even though his mainstream career only spanned 7 years, he's considered to be one of the most iconic and influential musicians in the history of blues music, and obviously one of the greatest guitarists of all time. Born and raised in Dallas, Texas. Started playing guitar at age 7, inspired by his elder brother, Jimmy. Actually dropped out of high school and moved to Austin, where he gained a following after playing gigs on the local club circuit. Formed the band Double Trouble, became a huge part of the music scene in Austin. And then eventually, in 1983, they came out with their first album, Texas Flag. During the majority of his life, he struggled with drug and alcohol addiction. He also struggled with the personal and professional pressures of fame and his marriage. It says that he successfully completed rehabilitation, began touring again with Double Trouble in 1986, and his fourth and final studio album, while he was alive anyway, was In Step. And he actually headlined Madison Square Garden in 1989 and the Beale Street Music Festival in 1990. And then later in 1990, Vaughan and four others were killed in a helicopter crash in East Troy, Wisconsin, after performing at Alpine Valley Music Theater. So that's really sad, man, because it seemed like he was just hitting his peak. Obviously, he had a few albums, but he was just rising to the top, man. So, and then everything stopped, you know. Fortunately, that's life. But I feel like we should do his song, Texas Flood. From the album Texas Flood, like I said, the debut studio album, 1983. But I feel like we should do the live version. You know, if you want the true experience of Stevie Ray Vaughan, I feel like this is the perfect starter. Now, this was live at the Mocambo Club in Toronto, Ontario, during the Texas Flood tour. I think we're in for a real treat here. I've seen this before. You guys haven't. You haven't even heard the studio version of the song. So it will be a reaction. So let's get into it. This is Stevie Ray Vaughan, Texas Flood.
Swaggy boy, straight swaggy.
And that whammy bar right there.
Come on, man.
Already. I'm not coming in yet. Looked like he was about to go to the mic and start. He's like, no, I kind of just want to play some more. Yeah. This is absurd.
Yeah, this is crazy that someone could just play like this. With basically his eyes closed.
My God, man. So he's like, oh, I see what you're doing there.
Like the guy's hat.
Which one?
The red.
Yeah.
Both of them.
That hair.
on lots of dough. World's flooding down in Texas. All of the telephone lines are.
You gotta be kidding me.
Oh my
man.
Goodness.
Are you serious? Ooh. You cannot convince me that he is human. There's no way, man. How can someone be that talented? How can you play guitar that good and sing? Sing well.
It's God-given, baby. God-given talent.
He was from another planet, man. I mean, my God. Man, imagine somebody seeing this for the first time. First time they ever saw SRV, and he's, you know, going all over the place on the guitar. And then you hear him sing, and you're like, what?
It does fit, though.
Yeah, he has, like, the perfect blues voice.
Yeah, it does fit.
Oh, man. And he's just feeling the music.
Oh, yeah.
You can see, man. But, yeah, this is just so absurd. I can't even.
World is flooding down in Texas. All of the telephone lines are down. Call my baby. Lord, I can't get a single sound. Well, the clouds are rolling. Mine and I'm standing out in the rain. Mine and I'm standing out in the rain. Well, the water keep rolling. Mine's about to drive from Stevie Ray inside.
Look, if you're going to talk in third person, you better be good.
Oh, yeah.
He's allowed to do that.
Otherwise, it's just like, really? Don't do that.
Yeah, and that's actually not the original
it's not
lyric
the line,
in the song. So.
Yeah, you got to be good to be throwing your own name in songs like that.
Yeah.
Man, oh, man.
And only the greats speak in third person.
Right. And obviously, this song is about a flood. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All the telephone lines are down. You can't talk to nobody, man.
Oh, yeah. That's tragic.
Better hope that rescue comes. And we're fortunate that we've never really been
in a big massive flood. Yeah.
Really. I mean, here in Louisville, we don't really have to worry about natural disasters that much. A flood is probably the worst thing that could happen.
Yeah.
My dad got stuck in a flood before.
Yeah, that's true. Other than that, man, we're usually pretty good here. But, you know, a flood's not fun.
Oh, no.
But
especially when it's your basement. Oh, man.
Yeah.
This sucks.
This is fun, though.
Well, the water keep rolling. Mine's about to drive from Stevie Ray inside.
Come on.
Thank you.
crowd was so amazed they couldn't even yell.
Sweating. Boy, look at that. He is sweating hard.
If I was there, I would have been going crazy, boy. Him doing all that. Man, I don't know why I can stay quiet. You're crazy. Gives you time to cheer.
That guitar needs a break, man. Give me a 5-minute break. It's just so smooth. Mm-hmm.
Crazy.
How's he doing it? Oh my gosh.
It was too easy for him. It was too easy.
He said.
Yeah.
He had to up the difficulty.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my goodness.
It was light work for him, man.
Yeah, it is crazy. This is just crazy.
No, that's just outright ridiculous.
He needed the challenge.
He can't see. He can't see the guitar.
Dude, that's like Michael Jordan at the free throw line shutting his eyes. Exactly what that's like. He's just showboating.
Yeah.
Like, this is too easy for me. Mm-hmm. Let's show you what else I can do real quick. Dude, that is absolutely
while I'm
ridiculous.
At it.
That is ridiculous.
Sunshines
every day.
Jesus Christ.
My goodness gracious.
You just got to bow to that, man. We are not worthy.
Yeah, and I love how the band just, the whole time, just plays the same beat.
Yeah.
Every time. They just stay out of the way. Yeah, just stay out of the way.
Yeah.
Man, oh man. That is one of the greatest performances I've ever seen. Are you serious? What a talent he was.
How many views does that have? Because that should have
a billion. Not enough.
That should have a billion.
He said, not enough.
That should have a billion.
That's a good point you bring up because, look, I know music evolves, and I don't like to compare genres, you know. At the end of the day, music is subjective. I understand that. But I can understand when the older generation says that music isn't the same anymore. This is a perfect representation of that. Because nowadays you have, you know, Bob the Rapper or Sally the Singer live at the Grammys, lip-syncing on stage to a song they didn't even write. Compared to this, this guy with every fiber of his being is putting his heart and soul into this song.
Basically making half of it up on the spot.
Profusely sweating. I mean, come on, man. I can understand it. Those performances and music that's out today, it gets a billion views, like you said. This is what should get a billion views.
Yeah, this should.
This is a course in music right here. This is a crash course. I mean, I don't care what genre you like. Everybody should watch this video. Like I said, though, Stevie Ray Vaughan accomplished so much in, what I say, like, it was like 7 years in the mainstream or something like that, if that. Yeah, just imagine what he could have accomplished. I mean, seriously, he already has legendary status. Imagine if he was still alive today, Ryan.
Right.
I can't imagine there's too many people that could have replicated that.
Mm.
Rest in peace to one of the greatest of all time. That was phenomenal. But yeah, that's the end of the video, guys. Please tell us what you thought about that song. We love hearing your feedback. Please tell us your views. Thank you for subscribing and hit that notification bell.
Peace out. Find your dreams come true.